What's going on, guys? Welcome to the video. So today we're going to do another online arbitrage sourcing tutorial. It's been probably about a month or so since I've done the last one, and I figured it was time to add another one to the list and, you know, the tutorials of that playlist. So if you guys are interested, the entire playlist is always linked in the description for these. It will run you through, you know, probably about 20 to 30 now online arbitrage sourcing tutorials that will literally show you how I find products online that make me about 5 to 10 grand a month through online arbitrage. Now we're gonna use Snagshout today. I'm gonna run you through another tutorial, and I basically just ran through in the last 5 minutes and picked a bunch of them that looked like semi-decent. It'll give us, you know, different examples of good products, and I've also outlined some here that are actually bad products that you might not necessarily see at first glance. So I'm gonna explain why they're bad products and why you should potentially stay away from them, and the types of problems that can arise if you try to source a product like this. So we'll run through, what is there, about nine examples from Snagshout. Now, before we actually jump into the tutorial and what we actually do, I have actually launched the premium course, Online Arbitrage Pro, back on Teachable. So I put it all on Teachable, organized a lot better. I think that the entire student experience and kind of the learning process is a little bit easier and better organized on Teachable than it is on my actual website. So two things. First and foremost, if you're in the Online Arbitrage Pro course, simply email me to Bryan. That's Bryan with a Y. I'll pop it up on the screen right now, at bgmediainnovation.com, and just message me your order number if you want to access the Teachable course. So it's the same course, basically. It's just on a different platform. If you want access to the other platform, message me, or I keep saying message me, email me your order number, and I'll just give you a coupon code for free so that you can access it. Now, if you're not in the Online Arbitrage Pro course, it has been about probably a month or so since I've given away coupon codes, so we're gonna do another 5. So it's been a while. I figure 5 more people into the course, I'll give 5 more coupon codes away. So before I actually give you the coupon codes, though, we're gonna hop over to Online Arbitrage Pro, like you see here. Just go to onlinearbitragepro.com, and that should take you right to the landing page of the course. And usually it retails for about $295, but today I'm gonna give away 5 coupon codes for 50% off. So if you use the coupon code OA Pro, you can get 50% off the purchase price of the course. So it won't be $295 anymore. It'll be roughly like $145 or $147 or something like that, whatever 50% of that actually comes to. Now, there is only 5 coupon codes, so keep that in mind. As soon as they go, that's it. It's been about a month since I gave coupon codes away. I'm not sure exactly when I'm gonna give away more in the future. I'm trying to control the amount of people in the course. But if you wanna get Online Arbitrage Pro 50% off, act now because they do go fast. So let's move on to the sourcing tutorial. Now we're gonna use Snagshout, like I said. So what I like to do on Snagshout is I'll do 3 things, right? I always click show prime only because sometimes you can get drop ship products from AliExpress. So always click the show prime only right here. Then I either go sourcing from biggest savings percentage, biggest savings by dollar, because then sometimes you can be spending more. So you might be paying like $5 to $10 potentially on a product, but the margin's a lot higher. Or I'll go lowest first. So lowest first means like you're paying like 25 cents or 99 cents or 50 cents usually is where it starts. Sometimes they're free every once in a while. That's lowest first. So that's like lowest purchase price with the coupon. So for today, I did the biggest savings by percentage, and that's how I sourced it. So we're gonna run through a couple of different examples here and exactly why they're good or bad products. I haven't actually checked into these. I'm literally sourcing like I would any other day. I just picked out a bunch of products that look potentially good. 2 of them that stuck out to me as potentially bad, and we'll run through examples. So this is a good example initially. Now, I always say roughly a $10 profit margin. So that's about what the retail price of the actual product is on Amazon, which you see here, it's listed at $11.71, and the coupon code price is $199. So $11.71 minus $199 is a little bit under $10. But it's roughly $10. That's why I wanted to use this as an example. People sometimes take that as like my gut, like the word of the gospel or something like that. And they're like, oh, you know, it's $9.99. I can't get it because it's not $10. That's just a rule of thumb. So if it's around $10 and it looks good and all the numbers check out and you can actually sell it, go ahead and grab it and source it. So let's check it out on Amazon. I did again probably forget to sign into Jungle Scout. So I'm gonna have to sign in real fast and then we'll hop back in. All right, back on to Amazon right now. This one looks like it's currently unavailable. So it looks like they're out of stock. So that negates that one. It's a bad product, let's avoid it. Now this is one, here's 2 examples of bad products for you. So this, I don't know if it's a bad product. This is probably a bad product and there's a reason for that. So you wanna stay away in a lot of, when you're doing the coupon arbitrage, and if you go to that online the arbitrage playlist, you'll see three different methods that I basically use to source, right? The majority of them are going to be coupon arbitrage with sites like Snagshout, like you're seeing here. Coupon arbitrage is slightly different than the bulk deal arbitrage and the liquidation pallet arbitrage, slightly different. So when you're doing coupon arbitrage, about 90 to 95% of the products that you're going to go ahead and buy are going to be sold on Amazon.com. That's why we're going to check the sales, or we're going to check the sales velocity and check to see if we can sell them on Seller Central, right? So when you're doing that, you want to avoid usually clothing items and jewelry, because it's hard to kind of gauge whether they're good items or not. Now, I have found good jewelry products. I have found good clothing products that have good coupon codes that you can make money on. Just in my experience, and I've been doing this for about 2 years, about 9 out of every 10 ones that you're going to potentially look at as good potential jewelry or clothing products tend to be bad products, and they look good a lot of times, but they're not. So I would just say stay away from them unless you want to do your homework on them. So I'm going to show you an example, two examples here of why they might be bad. So this one's currently unavailable as well, figures, as I'm trying to show you a tutorial. Let's see if this one's unavailable as well. So this one retails right here. That's a major red flag, right? It tells you that it retails at $99.90 and you get it for $9.99. You click on it and it's only retailing for $11.65. So that's a bad product. Now, one of the things that you'll see, and I've seen this from time to time, is it will actually retail at $99.99, right? For a jewelry specifically. And it's clearly, you know, not sterling silver, it's not gold, or it's not real diamonds most of the time on Amazon. So it looks like a good product, but what people are actually doing is they're trying to make $9.99 on this product by giving you a coupon code. They're not actually trying to make a $99 sale and generate coupon codes for that to get reviews or get sales like that. So if that makes sense, let me know if you have a question down below in the comments if that confuses you. But basically what I'm trying to say is stay away from jewelry, stay away from clothing. It's very, very, very difficult to gauge a good product, and you really have to do your homework. So that leaves us with the rest of them, which is a good thing because they're a lot easier to gauge and test to see if they're good products. So this one says it retails for $25.99. You can get it for $2.60 on with the coupon code. So let's check it out. Now, this is a little bit of a red flag, as I see here. First of all, it doesn't have any reviews, which, you know, if you've taken my course or if you watch any of the endless tutorials on YouTube that I have in that playlist, you'll notice that I looked initially for two things, okay? First and foremost, is the retail price exactly what they listed at? No, it's not, right? Because they say $25.99 and it's retailing for $17.99, which means that they lowered the price fairly recently, right? So that doesn't necessarily mean that it's a bad product, but it's just an indicator that, hey, they could change the price or lower it in the future, right? Which shrinks your margin after you buy it. So that's just something to worry about and keep in mind. Also, the second thing that I noticed, it doesn't have any reviews. Now, you can buy products that, you know, with a different retail price, and you can buy products with no reviews. It's just a red flag that I say to watch out for. So if we scroll down and pretend everything else is good, let's check it out. First thing you want to do is take the ASIN and make sure that you can sell it, right? Because if you can't sell it, it doesn't matter about the margin unless you want to resell it back on eBay, Mercari, or Poshmark, then it becomes all right. But if you're trying to resell it back on Amazon because you know that there's a market for it and you know the price and you know that there's a margin, you always want to check to see if you can sell it first. So let's see. You can sell it in new and used conditions, sell yours. So this is a potentially good product. If we go back to it, now you'll see here that it's ranked 49,000 roughly in tools and home improvement, right? So that's pretty solid. I always say to keep it under 100,000 bestseller rank if you don't use the Jungle Scout Chrome extension. But I always recommend for the people that are cherry picking to use the Jungle Scout Chrome extension. The reason being, if you click the extension, it's simply going to give you the straight numbers. You don't have to play guessing games. You don't have to stay under 100,000. You 100% know for a fact that, hey, it's roughly selling about 90 sales a month, right? And about 5 per day. And this is the revenue that it brings in on a monthly basis, roughly. So that's why I recommend that. If you guys are cherry picking and you want the Jungle Scout Chrome extension, there's an affiliate linked in the description right next to the Online Arbitrage Pro course. Go ahead and grab that if you want it. It is a $99 payment, I believe, once a year. They changed it. It used to be a one-time payment. Now it's once a year, but it's still 100% steal, and it's going to pay for itself literally in the first week. It's almost a must. You don't need it if you're just starting out. You don't have a lot of money to spend. You know, make some money first, make some profit, then invest it into the Jungle Scout Chrome extension. But always go for the Jungle Scout Chrome extension if you can afford it. It's worth it, and it's going to save you a lot of time and a lot of hassle. And you do need the light. You don't need the pro. You don't need to go for the 197, just 99. So this one looks like it's a pretty solid product. The only red flag being is that it doesn't have any reviews, and then the retail price has been changed. If it depends on where you are in the spectrum of sourcing. So if you're just starting out and you just have like maybe $100 to get into this, or maybe you have $50 to get into this, you probably don't want to buy this, right? Because there's so many other great products to buy that you don't want to take a chance on a product like this. If you're more on the other side of it and you have a lot of money to spend and you're just looking for as many products as you can with good profit margins, then you're going to go ahead and buy this. So I'd probably go ahead and buy this because, hey, even if they drop it like $5, there's still a margin to be had there because you're buying it for $260, right? So I would personally go ahead and buy this, but it just depends on where you are and what you want to do. People always ask me, you know, for like the exact formula to find product. There's no exact formula to find the good profitable product. You just have to source products and you'll get better as you go. You'll start to notice red flags, bad products, good products, and mediocre products that you know you can make money on. This is probably in between a mediocre and a good product, but just keep that in mind. So there's no formula that you can just like basically put everything in and it's gonna give you the input. So this one's another potential one. Retails for $14.99. You can get it for the coupon price of $150, which means the margin's about, what is that, like a little bit over $13, right? So let's check. Now, this is not Prime, it doesn't appear. At least it doesn't look that way. Oh, it is Prime, okay. It just doesn't have a buy box. So it has a 3 out of 5 star rating, which generally speaking is not necessarily good, right? But we're not too worried about that because we're not investing in this listing long term. We're just going to flip a product on the listing and make a quick $13 or whatever it was. So that's okay. Now the retail price is $14.99, like they said, so that's a good sign. Now let's check into it a little bit more. So it's under 100,000 before we even run the Jungle Scout Chrome extension, so that's pretty good. Now let's check to see the ASIN. We'll copy and paste it into Seller Central and see if we can sell it. So you can sell it in new condition, okay? So that's a good product so far. Now let's run the extension just to be sure. 80 monthly sales, about a little bit under 5 a day, with an average revenue per month of about $1,200. So this is a good product. I go ahead and buy this. It's a $13 profit margin. That's a solid product. Now let's do 3 more really fast. This is a shady one. You know, this is another example of a bad product I grabbed. Electronics, you got to be careful with. So a lot of times in electronics, you can find great margins like this. With one buy, you're going to make like $100, right? Last one I bought, I think, was like 2 days ago, and the margin was like 95 or something like that. So it's pretty good. Now, you do have to be careful because with that higher potential profit margin comes a higher risk. A, you're going to pay more. So this one's obviously $16.80, right? But you also have to be careful that they're not just marking it up like a jewelry or clothing. So you have to do your homework with electronics as well. And here you see that it doesn't retail at $25, right? It's clearly saying it's $35.60. So the margin appears to still be there as a $20 profit margin, but that just is a red flag, something to keep in mind. So they're saying that this retails at $35.60. Let's check the rest of it out. Scrolling down, and by all means, guys, I go over this, all this stuff, countless times in the course too. So yes, if you're watching the tutorials, they're gonna help you, but they're just the beginner methods. You don't get all the other excess information that's gonna help you really scale up if you're serious about this. So people always ask me, do you go over this in the course? Yes, everything I teach in the tutorials is in the course tenfold. Let's check to see if we can sell it. And we can only sell it in used condition. So in this situation, there's a couple of things that I do, right? I either completely don't buy the product and just ignore it, or I'll buy it and sell it in used condition and literally sell it as used like new. But literally in the condition note, I'll say, this is brand new practically. It's never been opened, never been used. And a lot of times that will sell pretty quickly, but it won't sell obviously as fast as if you get the buy box. So if you sell it in used like new condition and you put that condition report, so some people when they see the listing, right, there'll be a little thing up here that says, if we can find it, right here, used and new. So other people are clearly doing this as well, right? So you click the used and new. Not many people do this. Usually people just hit the add to cart, which is the buy box, right? But you'll see here, used like new. And usually right under the condition, you'll see used like new, and then mine will say, this is a new product. It's never been opened, never been used. And people can see that right here when they're deciding which one to buy. So it obviously increases your chance to potentially sell that product. If you bought this and tried to sell it as used like new, even though there's 4 other ones used like new right here, your chances of selling it used like new, it might take you 3 days, it might take you 2 weeks. It all depends on the product, it all depends on the amount of sales velocity and people coming to this listing for the actual product. Me specifically, if I were scaling up and I were trying to make a lot of money and I was more on that spectrum, I'd go ahead and buy this product and sell it as used like new, knowing that eventually it will sell and make me money. Now, if you're on the other side of the spectrum, if that were me and I only had like $25 or $100 to invest, I would just avoid this product altogether because I don't want to drop $1,680 of my $100, right, into a product that I might have to wait 2-3 weeks on. The whole idea for most people is to make money and make as much money, but make it as fast as possible. That's what I generally teach. But for me specifically, I'd probably buy this and just wait on it, knowing that I'm going to make the money eventually. And the margin's still about $20 because it retailed at, what was it? It retailed at $35.60, right? So you're going to buy it for, it's like the margin's like, what, $28 or $29 right there. So I personally go ahead and buy that one. Now, two more really fast. This one says it retails at $19.99. You can buy it for $3 with the coupon code. Now, there is no, it's not, first and foremost, it's not Amazon Prime, which is a major red flag I talk about in my course because it could be potentially drop shipped from AliExpress. So it's $19.99. That's a good sign that it retails for the same price they're claiming. It doesn't have any reviews. That's a red flag, and it's not shipped Amazon Prime, right? So that's shady. You might look at it as, hey, that's a good thing because if I buy it and ship it into FBA, I'm pretty much guaranteed to get the buy box at the same price because I have it FBA and it can be delivered to the customer a lot faster. Whoever's selling it right now is either merchant fulfilling it or they're drop shipping it. So you'd obviously get the buy box. Now that said, we want to check in to see everything else about this. And the very first thing that I see before we're even going to check the ASIN to see if we can sell it is it's $1.5 million roughly in home and kitchen. So nobody's buying this product. It's probably a drop ship product. And if we hit the extension, it'll probably tell us that there's less than five monthly sales, clearly less than five daily sales, right? So that's not a good product. That's something you want to avoid. Always be weird or wary, whatever that word is, of products that aren't being fulfilled by Prime. It's just a red flag. It doesn't mean that you can't buy products like that. I get that question a lot too. If everything else checks out, go ahead and grab it. But most of the time, they're going to be drop shipped. So last one we're going to check out is this hand towel or whatever this is. Retails for $17.26 and you can get it for the coupon price of $2.59, right? So a little bit under $15 profit margin. This is also shady because it's not fulfilled by Amazon. Now, their customer review, that's usually we don't care about customer reviews because there's one star, but because it's so low and it's not being fulfilled by Prime, it's probably not the best product to go after. Now, you can go ahead and potentially check it if you want. So it's selling 115,000 in kitchen and dining, so it might have a good sales velocity. Probably not, but sometimes in some, and this is why I say get the extension, because some categories are still selling relatively well at 115,000, but some categories, if they're 115,000, might be sales velocity like this. So you're not playing any guessing games. If this might have been like, clothing or jewelry or automotive potentially, it might have, 40 sales a month at 115,000. That's why I say get the extension so you know for sure, but this is obviously a bad product and something you want to stay away from. So I try to give you an example of a bunch of different products, good ones, for obvious reasons, mediocre ones and decent ones for, kind of hidden reasons, as well as bad ones for obvious reasons and bad ones that you kind of have to look into a little bit more. I try to give you the whole different, overview of all sorts of products that you can find here today. If you like this, please hit that like button. I genuinely appreciate it. I love doing these sourcing tutorials, although I don't want to literally every video that I put out be a sourcing tutorial for online arbitrage. I'll do a lot of them. It's been about a month that I've done one of these, so I figured, hey, what the heck, let's go ahead and do one. But I just wanted to bring you some value today and teach you how I make money with online arbitrage and how I source online arbitrage products. Remember, if you guys want to watch more of these tutorials, there's a link in the description for the entire online arbitrage playlist that will literally show you about 30 tutorials running through this. Furthermore, if you want the course at 50% off, there is only 5 coupon codes from the moment that I launched this video up until they're gone. Go ahead and snag it. Go to onlinearbitragepro.com, or there's a link to the Online Arbitrage Pro course in the description. Use the coupon code OAPRO that's up on the screen right now for 50% off while there's still coupon codes left, because once they're gone, that's it for probably another month or two. I'm not sure exactly when I'm going to drop more coupons. So hope you guys like this tutorial. And with that being said, I'll see you in the next one.